Good afternoon and welcome to the very short NCBI minute on alerts for new data. As per usual, this recording as well as the slides will be available both in the YouTube channel, the webinars playlist, and on our FTP site. You can find links for those things here, and I'll give you just a minute to copy those links down. All right, so over the next few minutes, we're going to talk about setting up alerts for new data using MyNCBI. I'm Ben Busby. I'm the bioinformatics training lead here at NCBI, and I have with me Peter Cooper, who is the head of the NCBI Education Group. So many of you most likely use NCBI literature resources, and many folks are very used to using MyNCBI to do regular literature searches. However, many of our users do not know that you can also save searches for data. For example, for new assemblies or annotations, for new geo data sets, or even for new SRA data sets. And I'm just going to walk you through how to do that over the next few minutes. So the majority of you probably know that MyNCBI is simply a way to have an account at NCBI. And it's trivial to sign up for a MyNCBI account. In fact, when I was preparing this webinar, I signed up for a MyNCBI account simply such so that I could have fairly clean demonstration slides. So it's a reasonably easy thing to do. There are many folks out there with MyNCBI account, and I highly encourage you to get one. So creating alerts from any search string in MyNCBI or NCBI is quite simple. Really, all one needs to do is click the Create Alert button below the search that they're already doing. So say I was searching geo for Alzheimer's and human. I might only want data series, as I've shown here. Then I can click the Create Alert button, and the alert dialog box would come on. I could modify my search terms. I could name my saved search. I typically use the defaults, but if you were to do a lot of these, I could see how you'd want to name them in a more systematic way. You can keep your filters or not, and there are a bunch of ways you can get email updates. So this is really quite simple to use, and a lot of people have told us that they would like to see this service, which in fact exists. As I mentioned earlier, you can also get alerts for bacterial annotation and assemblies. This is particularly useful, in my opinion, in the microbial realm. For example, if I wanted to see new releases of Salmonella, either assemblies or annotations, I could do this search in the NCBI assembly database. I believe personally that the NCBI assembly database is a very, very clean and useful resource for finding genome assemblies. Also, if you were to do SRA searches, for example, for metagenomes, you could do that. The search I've done here is for digestive decontamination, a fascinating thing that is sometimes done to folks, patients in intensive care units. And here you can see a time course of such experiments. Interestingly enough, you can blast into this time course to look at different bacterial gene loci that return to the human gut after this massive course of antibiotics. But this search I could also save, once again, simply by clicking on the Create Alert icon. Another nice thing that MyNCBI will do for you that many folks don't know about is it'll save custom tracks, both track configurations that you can set up in the NCBI Genome Data Viewer by clicking on the Tracks button, but also data that you upload. So here I've uploaded a file called test.bed, and MyNCBI will save that. So as with all of our resources, we have documentation. You can get those from the NCBI Learn page. And if you just Google for NCBI webinars, it's an easy way to find the NCBI webinars page. My favorite way to get to this documentation page is to go to NCBI/learn, and then you'll be able to go to the documentation. Once again, an updated version of these slides will appear on the FTP site in approximately 1 hour from now, and some of these links will be a little bit more simple. Another thing I do in my position at NCBI is I run hackathons. We have a bunch of hackathons coming up. So if you can do some, if you're pretty familiar with Linux and you can do some basic scripting, you're interested in bioinformatics or medical informatics, you should consider coming to one. And these are the hackathons we have coming up right now. And there look to be some interesting ones also shaping up for spring of 2018. In my group, I also have intensive internships for grad students, postdocs, and clinicians. So you can come work here for 4 to 6 weeks on either your project or ours in a collaborative environment and leverage NCBI resources for that kind of thing. So we ask that you document the stumbling blocks that you run into at NCBI. So if that's something you're interested in, please email bioinformatics training at NCBI. And with that, what I'd like to do is take some questions, take any questions that you may have, and there are questions I do not know the answer to. We'll either answer them on the FTP site, or Peter Cooper can answer them in person. I see no questions up here on the question bod. It's obviously a pretty simple and straightforward NCBI minute. So if there are any questions, I'll give you about the next minute or so to type them in. If not, I hope you all have a good day and a fantastic rest of the week. Thank you for coming to this NCBI webinar. And if you have feedback about the webinar, if you would have liked to see more or some, you know, us to dwell longer on a specific thing, please feel free to email webinars@NCBI or actually just put those comments right here in the question. All right, fantastic. Well, I don't see any questions. Thank you to those who said thank you. And like I said, I hope everyone has a fantastic week, and good luck with your research or whatever else it is you do.